Hello and welcome to a new video on the channel. Today we are going to do a little project that has been going on for a while for me. I am installing these facelift tail lights for the Toyota MR2. So, like I said, at first I'll be showing you how to install these, but I'm going to install them in a special way, which I'm going to explain later. So, first of all, I said like this is a project that has been going on for a while. And that is because that these tail lights were in pretty bad shape. So I'll put up a picture right now. These things were scratched up like crazy. They were faded. These black borders were just gone. And I thought I was scammed. It looked pretty hopeless. But I went to a local detailing shop and they looked at these tail lights and they said, we might be able to do something with them. So at first I asked them if they could redo these lines and polish the tail lights. However, they started working on it and they said they were pretty surprised because it's apparently Toyota made some pretty good durable plastics. So what they did is they referred me to their painter. The painter just sanded down the complete lights. He sprayed the borders gloss black and applied a clear coat. And these things actually look brand new right now. So if you want to restore cookie tail lights, just bring them to a professional paint shop. It will work out for these lights. They're pretty good quality. So none of the deep scratches, because this one isn't even had like a very fat scratch in it. It's just not visible anymore. It's crazy. And after that, the detailing shop applied two layers of ceramic coating on these. So one layer against scratch protection and one layer against the chemical protection. So basically what ceramic coating is known for, so that water and all of the chemicals will not bind. So these will stay clean for very long and won't be ugly like they used to be anymore. But like I said, this is going to be a special install because I do have a complete set with the lock, the brackets, everything. However, I'm not going to install the facelift center panel. So why I'm not doing that is several reasons. First of all is these bad boys. So you need to do some actual wiring to get everything to work because the plugs don't work on the pre-facelift model. So these plugs only work with the facelift models. And second is that for these lights, you'll need to dent or cut holes in the back panel behind it. And in a country like the Netherlands, that's just asking for rust problems. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to reuse the Zenki panel, which I think also looks a bit more unique. But I'll be reusing that. It's been modified, so I'm going to show you what I did to it. So right here I have the Zenki panel. So something you'll notice with these pre-facelift panels, if you start removing them, they're pretty old. So what happened is that these screws popped off. I just ripped them off. That can happen, but used some two component glue and it's just pretty much stuck again. Just let it dry for a day and it's all right. So make sure to use gloves when applying this stuff because it's not good for your skin. Just a little safety warning, but let's have a look to what I have done to the panel. So what you need to do with this panel is actually create like the curve of the light inside of it. So I think we've overdone it a little bit, but we're going to see how it worked out and if it all is going to fit. But you need to have the curve inside of it, and if you do that, it will pretty much fit. So how did I do it? I made a little cardboard mock-up of the facelift panel, and I just had it next on this panel. You get a little pen or a pencil, and you draw like the line on the panel. And so I'm not very good in cutting and sawing, so I've had some help with that. But so pretty much we got a little curved saw right here. We don't have like one of those electric things with a disc. So that's usually how people do it. We did not have one, so we just did it with a regular hacksaw. You know, it's not as clean, but you probably won't notice it. And if you will notice it, I'm going to look for a little solution. But I'm definitely keeping this panel because I just really like the look of it. So at first we will need to remove the current tail lights, of course. So we will start by removing this little side marker over here. Just press it and you'll be able to pull it out. But I'm going to do that off camera because I need both my hands free. So with some pressure this one should click right out. And then we'll need to remove these two little screws. So I'm lucky I have a European car, so there is no light in here or something, otherwise you'll need to tuck it back in here. So I'll just prefer to use a screwdriver, because by using electrical tools you'll probably ruin these old plastics, which are pretty fragile. So make sure to remove these two little screws. So when you're done, make sure to repeat the process with the other side as well. And also don't forget to put the screws somewhere where you will not lose them, because you'll need to go to Toyota if you lose these types of screws, and it will cost you some unnecessarily money. But for the next step, we'll need to open the car. Open up the trunk, and when you do that you will see this piece of plastic trim. So you will need to remove this one, so slightly apply some pressure to make sure it will come loose like that. Don't go too crazy because you will break some clips. It's all old plastic, so nothing broken yet. This is how it should come off, and you'll get some holes in here. So right now we will need to go behind the carpet, and I will show you how to properly remove this one without damaging these clips, which happens a lot with these cars. So to remove the clips you will need a thin object. I prefer to use one of these things, don't know the English name, but just get one of the thinner ones. It will work out. And then you go right here and you see this little thing in the middle. You need to press that one out of this little clip. So there we go. So when you push it out, it will probably fall in the back of the car, but no worries, because you'll be able to go there. But so I will remove this one, and there is a little piece, if I can reach it. Yes, so it can happen that it falls all the way back there, just gets a small little thing, don't know the English name, just something small that you can squeeze between there and pull it out, or maybe like a magnetic screwdriver or something. You'll get there. So what you need to do right now is grab these brown pieces of plastic and you need to pull them off these bolts over here. So you get this one and you pull them off, same with the other one, and then you get the 8mm. You remove this screw behind here and behind here, and when you're done with that you get screwdriver. You remove this screw and this one, and then everything should come off. So right now we should unplug the lights, and that is with this plug right here behind the carpet. So I already unplugged this one, and now we should also do the one over here. So you have this little thing here and you can just push it out. If you push the button, should go easy, but you need two hands to do it, so I'll put the phone away. So right here, this one is loose as well, and as you can see, everything should be able to come out right now. So let's start off with the first light, and there we go. So it clicks very easily out of these brackets over here. Here is the hole where the plug goes, but again, I need my two hands. So I found out how it popped right out, so I'll show it with this one, which should come loose as well. Yes, so you see this piece of rubber, so that I thought that would become an issue, but you just need to yank it really hard and it should go out like that. So the last step is removing the center panel. So if you're removing it for the first time, it is going to be very hard. You need to yank it very hard. Things are going to break on this panel, but this is my spare panel, which I removed some things to make it easy, and I'll show you how it works. So it goes out really easy now, right now. So if you watch here, usually here and here are some clips that pop in right here. So when you're putting back the panel, make sure you remove these clips, because those clips are the ones that make it very hard to remove the panel. So how I removed it, I just pulled it very hard, two screws came loose, and the clip still sat in right here. So I broke this little piece of plastic. So what you should do to finally remove this is you get a hacksaw, saw it right off, and make sure that this is just without any clips. It will make your life so much easier. So what you're going to want to do as the next step is swap the hardware of the Zenkey light over to the Cookie Tail light. And the reason why you want to do this is because this little piece of insulation hardware is different than the pre-facelift one. So this one will not fit. And both wiring harnesses also have different plugs. So as you can see, these are different. So what you're going to want to do is grab these light bulbs. You want to unlock them by twisting it. So I'm going to need two hands for that. But you'll get the point if you start to do it. And you want to get a screwdriver, screw these loose, and place them on here. So I actually got some replacement screws because I thought these would be very rusty, but it turns out that mine are still in very clean condition, so I'm not going to replace them. But if you need the product, the part code, it's over here. You might want to get a few spare screws. So right now this insulation hardware is on the Cookie Tail lights. I've twisted these, so these pop right out. So we won't be needing these. You're going to place these ones in the Cookie Tail light. However, there is one thing we need to do, and that's we need to remove this bulb for the reverse lights, because we will not be needing this one. So you want to line up the light bulbs inside of the new light. But right now is where the tricky part comes in, because these little pieces of plastic actually do not fit in here. But you can pop them right in, and that is, you do that by finding a little sweet spot. So as you can see, there are these pieces of plastic right on the side over here, if you look at this, and there are some small holes over here. So you need to find a spot where every piece of plastic lines up with a hole, and then you need to press it, so you can't twist it in like the original light bulbs. So I'm going to find the sweet spot, and then I'll show you how to push them in. So as you can see right here, I found a little hole for every piece of plastic, and then you can just push it in. Give it a small little twist if you can manage to do it, and then it sits inside of your light. And now you need to repeat the process for the two
other light bulbs. So the hardware for both lights are swapped over. If you want, you can tuck away the harness in these small little holes if you want to make sure that there is not as much wiggle room for the wires. So you if you want to be sure that this definitely does not come off. When you're done with that, I am going to clean up this little Zenki panel and I'm going to test fit if everything fits right now. So we'll see. So this is a little test fit with everything not plugged in and it seems to go pretty well. However, we have a slight fitment issue. So if you look at this one, I believe that this will go very well. Obviously needs to be screwed down right here, because here's you can play with it, let's say like that, but it will meet the little screw hole right here. However, this side gets fitment issues, because right here it will not fit. And if you look at here, is over here, there is, it hits over here and down here, which prevents it from clipping into the back panel. So we'll need to get a tool, get a little bit work done on these parts, and we'll move on from that. Let's see if we can fix it. So the part back here is mainly where it hits, so I'm going to see if I send this back, if it will fit better. So I got this little thing and I will just see if I can sand this down, or if I need to get some heavier weaponry to get this thing to fit. So yeah, let's see. So it turns out removing a bit of plastic down here should be enough for a good fitment. It clips right in right now. So if we press this right here together, the screw should be able to go in. Same as for here. So I think that's a win. Unfortunately for me, I have to go to work. But luckily for you, the magic of editing exists. So I'm just going to leave everything how it is right now. It's clipped in. I'm not going to drive the car. I'm going to off to work and continue everything tomorrow, and hope and pray everything goes well. Because if you own an MR2, you know what happens with MR2s. When you think it works, it starts to fight back. So let's have our fingers crossed that this was the only battle with the MR2. So I have returned, and after taking a second look, I think I need to do a little bit more trimming, because if you can see right here is that there is a slight tilt under here. So I think that, like at the other side, under here we need to do a little bit of trimming to make sure that this one fits well with the panel, because as you can see is that it kind of lifts above here and I can't push it down because it gets held back over here. So let's trim that down again and hope that the lights will fit after that. So right now I have done some more trimming and I'm 100% sure that right now I can screw the top screws back in. So what I'm going to do first is plug in these plugs and make sure that all the lights are working, because it would be a shame to install everything back and find out that some of the lights broke. So as you can see, what I've been afraid of is one light is not working. So I'm thinking it's a cable issue. I'm going to fiddle around with that a little bit and see if that will fix the issue. So I've managed to get it to work. So I think I broke the light bulb that was in here. So I grabbed one of the light bulbs out of the harness of these cookie tail lights, and that one seems to work fine. So yeah, let's put on the blinkers and the fog lights, because that is going to be important as well. Let's have a look. And the large lights. So that seems to work. It does at the right, it does that, and at the left, not. That's a little bit weird, but I kind of think that's a funny little detail. Just don't know. It's probably cutting off electricity or something. I don't know. But let's find the rear big light. And those are working as well. So that's very nice. So the last thing to try it. Oh, and now it stopped doing that. Just a weird car, man. The last thing is to find out if the braking light is working. So I'm going to ask for a little help. And if that works, we're going to build everything back into the car. So the braking lights work as well. So it's time to put everything back together. I'm not going to show it, but you know the drill. Screw up here, in the back, remove the side markers and screw everything back on there. And of course, putting back the carpet and the trim. So make sure to not use electrical tools while doing this, because you'll easily shred through the old plastics and you don't want to do that. That's going to cause some major issues. And something you will notice when you screw everything together, so right now it doesn't fit really well, but as soon as things start to tighten, it will fit nice and snug on the car with every hole and everything. So I'm going to put everything back and then we'll look at the end result. So it is getting pretty dark, but the finishing touch has been done. The MR2 emblem is on. Everything is just bolted on very tightly. There's no issues. This will not come loose any soon. Pretty good job, if I say so myself. So right now, I think I'm just going to enjoy this. Maybe in the future I'm going to look maybe into putting some silicone seal in here or something. You know, this is very noticeable right now because I have the flash on, but normally you would not see this, but it's maybe not really watertight. Same goes for here. And I think that this center panel may need a little paint job or something. And reverse lights, I don't have them currently, so who knows, maybe I'll do the reflectors into reverse lights, maybe this little hole, because this lock does not work. Or maybe like somewhere under the car right here, like a Formula One style. I'll have to wait and see, but I don't daily this car, so I don't need it actually, really need it. It's more a convenience. But it's getting dark. I'm cleaning the car tomorrow, and then I'll make some nice shots of the taillights to see the end result. There it is, the Toyota MR2 Cookie taillights install, and I got to say I'm really, really happy with this. It really changes up the look of the car. It makes it look so much younger. I'm very happy with the rear panels. They actually don't look that bad. I was afraid that it would have a lot of holes. That was very easily noticeable that I cut into the Zenki panel. However, it's just, if you look at it, you can see it, but it's not extremely noticeable. I love the ceramic coating on these lights. I just washed them, and if you've seen, like you've seen in the montage, just the water falls off. It's amazing. So, yeah, I'm kind of happy right now. I don't have reverse lights, so maybe in the future if I have issues with it not having reverse lights, I might either convert like the reflectors, because that should be possible, or maybe like install somewhere here a reverse light or inside of a back window. But yeah, I'm not really looking at that right now. So I only have one little issue, and that's a little panel gap over here. Probably should tighten the screws behind there a little bit more. But overall, everything fits perfectly. So that is the install. Next up, we're going to do another install, the turbo hood engine lid for the car. Just complete the MR2 starter package. However, that's going to be in a few months when I have some more money. I need to financially recover from these expensive lights. But I do have the engine lid lying around, so the paint is only the issue. That's going to cost a lot of money. So yeah, make sure to leave a thumbs up on the video and subscribe for more Toyota MR2 content, car walkarounds, just car news, all that good stuff. Again, oh, and follow me on Instagram over here, Dutch Fake Ferrari. And yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching. And see you in the next install.